fucking shitty fucking fedora and go eat a dick.
Thank you.
I'm going to be impacted by my sunburn.
Oh, I don't think so. I think better people to ask.
Step right over to the plate.
Yeah, man. Let's see how this works. What's happening, guys? My name's Ian. I'm a straight white male, which means I'm the best. A lot of people not happy with the straight white male right now. I don't know why you guys hate us so much. Black rights, women's rights, gay rights. That's just some shit we gave you. There's no war. White man's never been defeated. Oh, you got fucked up by history. Oh, the white man's so terrible. I don't know if you know this, but that's how history works. You can go all the way back to the Bible. The Bible is a book about people that got fucked over by life. It's been rough since day one. You don't like it? Go try living in the forest. See how well nature treats you. Dave Chappelle put out a little mini special there. He said, we gotta start listening to the streets. The streets. The streets are talking. Really, Dave? You gonna listen to the streets? I don't know if you know this, but the streets are fucking retarded. The streets are full of retarded, stupid people, Dave. It's not a popular opinion to say, but if you've ever listened to hip-hop, you know the streets are the number one thing people are trying to escape. Listen to the streets. Fuck these streets. In the middle of a pandemic, these bitches are out there rioting. Fuck you and your mama, too. You're gonna get the whole goddamn world killed listening to these fucking Rube Scoots. Even John Stewart's like, now's our time to listen. I'm here to listen. Who you listening to, John? Pookie? Huh? You gonna listen to Pookie selling Lucy's? I can't breathe, he got the answers. Our dude that's wearing sandals and socks, those are the answers. That's the guy that's gonna solve systemic injustice. Where's my fucking intellectuals at? Thought you guys were so goddamn smart. How about you give me some goddamn answers? You need a comedian to figure it out? That shit ain't happening. A lot of people think that the solution is that to all this systemic injustice and people getting killed by cops is that we need more black cops. I don't know if you know this, but 90% of black people are actually killed by other black people. So making all the cops black is basically genocide. Listen to the streets, though. And people are going, oh, these police, oh, they can't have no bad apples. Can't have no bad apples in that job. It's not landing a plane. It's dealing with drunks. Have you met the general public? Have you met them on PCP? Because that's a cop's daily job. George Floyd got killed by a cop. That was terrible. Father's Day weekend, 116 people got gunned down on Chicago's South Side. By the way, that's not some George Floyd shit. That's just a weekend in Chicago. And you wonder why the cops are scared? You ever try to arrest someone on PCP? You ever try to catch a crackhead? It ain't fun. And that's just the drug addicts. You know they still got to deal with Karens too. Listen, I got this thing that makes me hate the general public. It's called the day job. And my day job is just dealing with chicken. And as a chicken man, if I had the authority that the cops have, you better believe people would be getting pistol whipped over their goddamn attitudes. A lot of people are mad because they see a cop kill someone and then it feels like nothing happened. Well, how about, while we got the cameras out, this is how we deal with the cops. You gather up a crowd and you go, hey, look, we got one. And you knock that stupid hat off their stupid head and then you cut the ribbons off their shoulders, you pull the badge off and throw it on the ground, you take the belt and all the different symbols of power that they got, whip that little red line off the side of their pants, kick them and spit on them, invite the crowd to spit on them, then you stick them in the back of the car and you give them a little due process. We do need to make some changes to the police. I think police, instead of being such an occupying force, instead of being scared every time I see them, we need to be more like the fire department. They're on demand. They're there when we call them. And we gotta break this shit up too. Systemic means that this is affecting the police as much as it's affecting us. Gotta put the system on trial. Remember that, Dave? Remember the apartheid talk you gave about Me Too? Let's put the system on trial, not the people. They're so anxious for blood. In one case, they fired five black cops for racism. I think we need a two-tier system. We need some regular ass cops to deal with all the small petty crime, domestic abuse, basic theft from your grocery store. And then we need the murder cops. The petty cops are your opportunity to comply. One of the biggest things you hear is, you know why people get killed? Because they don't comply. Well, we're going to give you some petty cops to petty apply. But if you don't apply, guess what? The murder cops are coming next, and they will step on your motherfucking neck. 116 people gunned down on Chicago South Side. You know who I feel bad for? The secretary out there. Because a secretary doing that paperwork on the South Side gets paid the same as a secretary in the middle of Nebraska, but she got 400 times the amount of paperwork to file on a daily basis. You know who should be mad about all this? Is the prison industrial complex. They should be like, hey, quit shooting all our free labor. I got a solution for you. Let's turn the police siren into the national anthem. Then you won't have to shoot black people to get them down because they'll already be kneeling. I've been seeing a whole lot of changes, a lot of superficial, artificial changes to the system. All these companies pretending to comply. Ooh, you pretending to comply. You making your stuff black, black, blackity, black, black. Oh, that's exciting. A lot of them are even offering new opportunities to black people. I've yet to see one company admit that they're actually racist. Wouldn't that be nice? Hey guys, turns out we are systemically unjust and racist, but we've acknowledged it and we're ready to move on. When's the last time you saw any acknowledgement from any company ever? I think I got a way we can fix all this. We need a systemic injustice placa. It's gonna be a certificate that you gotta apply for. I'm gonna put Louis Farrakhan, Oprah, and Kanye West in charge of it. They're gonna come by and inspect your company, and if you pass them, as long as you please them, you get a placa you put up, and we're just gonna go company by company. A lot of people are like, man, racism needs to be legal. It already is for companies. I don't know if you know this, but if you're racist on Facebook, you will get fired at Amazon. People don't like talking about racism because they think they're getting called racist. So let's change the vocab. This isn't about racism, this is about injustice. And injustice affects all of us. Did you know statistically, more white people get killed by cops than black people? So that means if we change the way we do policing so it's a little bit safer, white people are still gonna come out on top. This isn't about calling you racist. It's about taking stuff from the past that still exists in the present so that we can all have a better future tomorrow. We're out here looking for vengeance. We're out here looking for justice. If you're looking for justice, we're going to have some hard conversations about dealing with the people in charge. Here's something you need to get your head around. Good does not exist. It ain't real. It's not a natural force in the universe. There is no God in heaven who has told you what is right and what is wrong. What there is whatever's good to the dominant will to power is labeled as good. Even if that means exploitation and tears down here at the bottom. Who is in charge? In our case, it's, GE, the US government, China, whatever Illuminati shit turns out to be real. Those are the people that decide what's good. And what's good for them ain't always good for us. What's good for the prison industrial complex ain't necessarily good for us. If it's good for the dominant will to power, but bad for us, that's what injustice is. That's the problem that we need to fix. And the answer isn't vengeance, it's innovation. And that's why I'm here to say that in 2020, I'm voting for Kanye West for president of the United States of the goddamn America. All right, y'all. My name's Ian Ellis. I love you tonight.